Hi, this is Charting Man Dan of thechartguys.com, home of technical analysis education. Click the link for a free week trial, no credit card required, and gain access to our multiple live broadcasts daily, community chat room, educational videos, nightly watch lists, and more. Invest in your education and future and join the community today. Hey everybody, checking back in on gold, and boy has gold and the miners been fun the past 2 days. If you saw the past two videos each afternoon, we have been all over it. Gotta give props to one of our members. He has been all over gold and these miners doing fundamental research. We're all technical guys and gals, but bringing that knowledge to the table, showing that the move was overextended. I looked at some technicals as well and agreed with him. Got into some GDXJ calls, looking out for more earnings bulls to appear now that NEM, which was the first miner to report, had bullish earnings. So the bulls bought the dip in a big way. There's some indications we can look at here for what was occurring, and we were all over it with bullish entries at the end of yesterday and this morning. So here is gold, nice bullish candlestick. Middle Bollinger Band is still resistant at 1334. Weekly time frame, bullish candlestick with the lower wick showing the bulls buying the dip, and not a strong confirmation of that bearish reversal candlestick from last week. So I'm more interested in the shorter term time frames. Then we'll check in on the miners. So yesterday video, I pointed out the RSI on the hourly was oversold, and then I pointed out the 4 hour chart, how the RSI has not dipped below 30 except one time in 2016. Look at these bounces. Look at that perfect bounce off the 30 RSI, and that is a $20 gold move all over throughout today. So that is an extremely strong move, and I am looking for consolidation now. The RSI is at 70. We've seen a very strong bounce. We're at some key resistance here at 1334. You can see we topped out here before that dump, and we're topping out here again. So I would love to see a cup and handle pattern form here where you have your resistance, unable to break it after the dip of consolidation. Then you consolidate trading down sideways or slanted to the downside a bit, and then you break out to higher highs. So we'll see if that's how it ends up shaping up, but I do anticipate short-term consolidation in gold due to the strength that this bounce has occurred. And every time we saw market weakness today, when SPY hit a new leg to the downside, gold responded with a bullish move to the upside. Another pattern I was watching here towards the end of the day on the 5 minute, I posted this chart on StockTwits. 1328 key double bottom of consolidation. So after that set, that told me if 1328 breaks, it's going to see a quick drop, and we'll be looking at the next support down at 1322. So potential for a $6 drop and a nice entry into dust. That did not happen. We broke the downtrend resistance line and hit higher highs. So a clear bullish indication holding that support. But that is a key support now going forward. If 1328 breaks, we can expect some downside because of that little double bottom on consolidation. So let's now look at the miners. Like I said, I've got GDXJ calls for the end of August after these miner earnings come in. And we broke the high of yesterday. We closed over the middle Bollinger Band, and we're looking to fill the gap up at 47.58. So a very strong move on these miners. Those calls that I have are $44 calls that expire in 36 days, and they went up more than 33% from yesterday to today. So that lets you know the strength of this move. Big time gains on options that expire in over a month. So looking at the miners, we've got NUGT. Compared to GDXJ, it's not as bullish. We did not break the high of yesterday, and the middle Bollinger Band is still resistance, and JNUG is the same. So we're watching those middle Bollinger Band resistances going into tomorrow. All three of these miners need a green day tomorrow to confirm the bullish reversal candlestick that we saw form today. So that's what we're going to be looking for. We are seeing gold begin to consolidate here now after hours, coming back down towards that 1328 support. And we can see the hourly big red candlestick looking at consolidation to occur overnight tonight. So we'll check back in on gold again. Lots of fun. I'm anticipating lots of volatility and trading opportunity in both directions heading into these earnings. I flipped dust today for a couple $100 gain, but it's certainly nice to be playing in both directions. I had dust with my stop loss set, and I had my longer term GDXJ, and it felt really good, pretty much being comfortable with whatever direction went, knowing that my stop loss was in place and knowing that I would likely see some upside. So I did end up sending that dust, or flipping that dust 1,000 share lot for a couple $100 profit, and I'm still confident that GDXJ is going to see some nice gains over the next month. So we'll keep checking in, having a lot of fun with these miners. And again, can't give enough props to the members in the chat room. As this crash was going on, really level-headed and logical, technical and fundamental analysis going on, and really a team effort. And stock trading in the 21st century is now a team game. And that's due to technology and chat rooms, and it's a lot of fun. So come join us. Have a great night.